So, have you ever seen the world look like this? Or perhaps at nighttime you've seen lights on the back of cars look like this? If so, then the last time you saw an eye doctor, there's probably a good chance you heard them tell you, astigmatism, astigmatism. You have
astigmatism.
But wait, what exactly is astigmatism? Like, what is wrong with the eyeball, and should we be worried about this? I'm Dr. Joseph Allen, and today we're going to be explaining everything you need to know about astigmatism, including when you should be worried and what you can do about it. But first, what is astigmatism exactly? Well, the word astigmatism is derived from Latin, with a meaning without, and then stigma, which means point. So it literally translates to without a point. And how this relates to the eyes and how we see is that in a perfect world, all light would focus to a single point inside of the eye. But with astigmatism, light doesn't focus to one single point, it focuses to multiple points, and this creates almost like an oval shape of focus inside the eye. And this results in not only blurred vision, or vision that seems out of focus, but can also create almost like a fuzzing around the edges of words and letters. And in extreme cases, I've even had some patients tell me that they see double or a ghosting of images around words and letters. Now, technically there are different types of astigmatism of the eye, but the most common is that of corneal astigmatism, because that's where there is a deformity or warpage to the front clear window to the eye that we call the cornea. Here, we have an instrument in the eye clinic called a corneal topographer, which, just like doing elevation maps of a mountain, this device can map out very subtle deformities and warpages that cause elevation changes on the surface of the eye. So, to an eye doctor, this is actually what corneal astigmatism looks like, which sort of makes the surface of the eye look like it was maybe bent or pinched in a way. But because the surface of the eye is warped in this way, that is why people with astigmatism can see the world like it's almost stretched. And that's why you see these classic images of people like driving at nighttime, and all of the lights seem flattened and stretched out. In fact, when we test for astigmatism here in the clinic, we show different lenses in front of the eye, and some people can even notice this small shift and stretching of some letters. Now, other than the corneal astigmatism, there is technically what is called lenticular astigmatism, caused by the lens inside of the eye. But this is far less common, and if it does occur, usually happens more with age, just due to normal aging changes. Okay, so why? Why does this happen? Why is it that some people get astigmatism, and what causes it to change or get worse? Well, most cases of astigmatism are believed to be genetic, as astigmatism can run in families. However, astigmatism can occur as a result of some eye diseases and some other conditions, such as scarring of the eye. One example is that of keratoconus, which is where the cornea begins to progressively thin and then protrude outward of the eye in the shape of a cone. And this can sometimes result in high levels of irregular astigmatism, which can cause such blurred vision that even glasses can't correct for it sometimes. And because it is a progressive disease, then looking out for frequent glasses prescription changes is going to be important. So if you're somebody who frequently notices your glasses have to be updated like multiple times throughout the year, then keratoconus might be something to be concerned about. And have you ever heard a doctor say not to rub your eyes? We say that in part because there is a strong association between rubbing of the eyes and the development of keratoconus. Otherwise, because our bodies are always growing and changing, and little changes to the eye's anatomy can affect how we see the world, it's not uncommon to see small shifts and changes in your levels of astigmatism and correction for that. So, how do we correct for astigmatism and help improve your vision? Well, thankfully, most cases of astigmatism can easily be corrected with a simple glasses prescription. One bonus tip I do like to share is that when buying glasses for astigmatism, because the lenses often have multiple curves on them, then you want to get something that has an anti-reflective or an anti-glare coating. That'll help cut down some of the glare you may experience. Now, despite what some people may have heard, astigmatism can be corrected with contact lenses. In fact, most soft contact lenses now do correct for some level of astigmatism. In fact, we usually call those toric contact lenses. However, some people with higher levels of astigmatism, they may not fit into those soft lenses, and so they may need to be fit into more of a custom-designed contact lens, such as a gas-permeable contact lens or a scleral contact lens. And if you want to know more about different contact lenses and the options for correcting vision on the eyes, I do have several videos on that, and I'll put a link to those in the description for you. But what about LASIK? Well, the good news is that LASIK and other forms of refractive surgery often do correct for astigmatism, or at least to a certain amount of it. Now, there's many different factors that go into play if someone's going to be a good candidate for an eye surgery, so definitely a good question to ask your local eye doctor if you are a good candidate for that. Now, if you enjoyed today's video and learned something new, please do me a favor, hit that like button for me, as that will help this video reach more people. Also, leave me a comment and let me know your favorite part from today's video. If you are in the market for looking at new glasses and want some help with finding a good pair, or you want to learn more about contact lenses, then check out one of our videos coming up over here to the side. Otherwise, from here, Dr. Allen, hope you have an amazing day, and we'll see you in those next videos.